Today we are going to see the solution to numericals that were given in lecture 15. So this is the gearing diagram that was given to you, and the motor drives the front roller through these particular wheels, that is 33, 131, 84 and 33. This is how it goes. Motor, it drives this particular pulley through 33, then 131, then 84 and 33, which drives the front roller. So next was the back roller, and it is driven through these wheels 33, 131, 42, 109 and 66, which is the CP. So this is the route. Motor pulley 33, 131, which on this particular shaft there is a 42 wheel teeth over here, which drives this carrier 109 and 66, which drives the back roller. The middle roller is driven by the back roller through the wheels VG, which is a brake draft change pinion, 143 and 18. So this is the route, back roller V, then it drives this G, which drives the this G is the brake draft change pinion, which on the same shaft you will see that there is this one wheel over here, which is 143, and which is driving this 18 teeth wheel, which drives the second or the middle roller. So how to calculate the draft values of these are the draft values. Brake draft comes out to be 1.07, main draft 7.28, total draft 7.79. And the front roller surface speed, we can calculate from this, it comes to 258.9 meters per minute. So how the calculation goes like this. Front roller RPM is, suppose you take 1440 as RPM of the motor, then you multiply that by, assuming that this this pulley diameter is in between this range, so I'm taking it as 270. So 270 divided by 165, which is the diameter of this particular pulley, multiply by 33 divided by 131. Again, since this is the one which is driving this 84, so this is both acting as a driver as well as a driven. So 131 again in the numerator divided by 84 into 84 divided by 33. Again, 84 also acts like a carrier over here. So you get the surface speed, which is 258 meters per minute approx. Then you come to the back roller RPM. It goes in a similar way, 1440 into 270 divided by 165 into 33 divided by 131 into 42 divided by 109, which is a carrier. So again, multiply by 109 here and divided by 66, which is the CP. You get the back roller RPM as 377.73. And middle roller RPM would be which comes from the back roller speed. So back roller speed 377.73, which is then multiplied by 20 divided by 148 into 143 divided by 18, 143 divided by 18, which gives you the middle roller RPM. So for all of these front roller, back roller and middle roller, I can also find the surface speed which I'll be requiring for calculating the drafts. So it is pi into D diameter, which is given over here, 35 for front roller, into the RPM that we have just found out, which will come to 258 meters per minute. Then you come to the back roller surface speed, which is pi into D into N divided by 1000. Why we are dividing by 1000 is because the diameter is given in mm, so I divide by 1000, I get meters per minute, pi dn divided by 1000. Same thing for middle roller, I get the surface speed as 35.65 meters per minute. So how to calculate drafts? The draft values for brake draft, it is surface speed of middle upon back. So I take the values from the previous slide, I get these values and I get the answer as 1.07. Same for main draft. For main draft, it would be surface speed of front divided by middle roller, which comes out to 7.26, and total draft would be surface speed of front divided by back, which would come out to be 7.79. Now this total draft I could have calculated based on these two drafts that I have already calculated, that is a brake draft and the main draft. So looking at the formula, suppose I were to multiply the first two formulas, I would get surface, that I will get surface area of front upon back, which is nothing but the third formula for total draft. So when I replace this, I get break draft into main draft. So when I multiply both these values, I get 7.77, which is approximately equal to 7.79, which I got earlier. So total draft is a product of the intermediate drafts, which we must remember. It's not addition, it is a product. It is when we multiply the intermediate drafts, I get total draft. The difference in the two values above is seen due to the decimal rounding off, so we can just ignore it. So we come to the production problem that was given earlier, and we had been given the front roller speed as 258.9 meters per minute and the sliver delivered as 5 kilotecs. We had to calculate the production in kgs per hour, kgs per hour per machine with two heads, production in kgs per machine per shift of 8 hours at 100% efficiency, and these were the answers. So let us see how to calculate them. For calculation of production in kgs per hour, we take length of delivered sliver in meters per hour multiplied by linear density in kilotecs divided by 1000. So when I substitute from the values that I've got in the earlier slides here, this was in meters per minute, so I need to multiply that by 60 for meters per hour. And then linear density is given as 5, which I substitute, and divide by 1000, I get the answer as 77.67 kgs per hour. When I multiply that by 2, which is number of heads that is asked, that is a machine has two heads, it has been given to us. When I multiply that by 2, I get 155.34 kilograms per hour per machine. And if I want the answer in kgs per shift per machine with two deliveries, then I have to simply multiply this earlier figure for the machine, which was giving me the production for 1 hour, by 8, because I want now the kgs delivered per shift. So this is how we calculate production. So there was one more a problem which was given, and for which we need to revise all these formulas. We know that tex is equal to 590 divided 0.5 divided by English count. We also know kilotex is equal to tex upon 1000, and kilotex is equal to 590.5 divided by Hank into 1000. If we were to use that earlier formula, we would have length of the sliver delivered in meters per hour. We need to replace the kilotex by this particular formula here, 590.5 divided by Hank into 1000, and the earlier 1000 which was there in the formula would remain there. So this is your new formula if your delivered sliver is expressed in Hank in your production problem. So if the front roller runs at 258.9 meters per minute and the sliver delivered is 0.118 Hank, then we were asked to calculate production in kgs per hour. The answer was 77.74. Let us see how to calculate it. So kgs per hour would be length of the sliver delivered per hour in meters. Multiply that by 590.5 divided by 1000 into Hank into 1000. You get, by just substituting these values here, you get the answer as 77.74 kgs per hour. So that's it. We have solved the examples or the questions given in lecture number 15. Thank you.